Hello, last time in the loop shaping tutorial, we used this example to demonstrate how loop shaping design is executed. We obtained a solution based on this simplified kernel function. And today, I want to show you how the solution for this plant can be converted into a PID games. Let's take a look. This is from last time. From settling time, we obtain omega c, the crossover frequency. Okay. From the trend function, we obtain the original magnitude plot. And based on the desired loop gain shape and the original trend function, we designed this trend function solution as a controller. Okay. I just want to add one more thing here. K equals omega C, the inverse of this plant gain. Okay? And that will put the loop gain body plot almost exactly like this. Okay? Today, we are interested to turn this into a PID gains. Okay? The way we do that is to select a PID form. This is the PID with approximate differentiation. And you turn this into a numerator over denominator, clean up the coefficients, okay? And then compare this trend function with the trend function of the controller from our previous design. And to make the numerator equal, you make sure the coefficients are all the same. The coefficient of S squared equals coefficient of here, okay? And so on and so forth. So you have three equations from the numerator. And also you want to make sure 1/tau is 200. So tau is 1/200. Okay. So you do this calculation and you find the Kp, Ki, Kd. Okay. And that's it. That's the solution. Okay. And this is another way of tuning PID, but this way is systematic. You are guaranteed with some phase margin. And you know what you're doing. You know what your limitations are on high frequency and low frequency. So this is a very systematic way of tuning PID. We know there's over 1500 rules or methods of tuning PID. Okay. But I think if you understand how to use this one, you only need one method. Okay. That's all for today. If you have any questions, just put in the comments box. Thank you.